Hi guys.
I'm hoping that you can hear me because the microphone is up there at the moment because I can't really have it pinned to me when I'm moving around. Sorry, I'm looking at the screen over there. Camera is there, screen is there. So welcome to the new layout for this stream. I've just realised that it has switched my screens and I'm looking over there because I can't actually see it. There we are. So for this stream only, you might notice that up there I have a second camera which you can see me crouching because the laptop is actually sitting on my printer. And I'm just checking how far the microphone actually is away from me. It's actually quite far. So I'm not sure how well you can hear me. So I have two cameras today. One of them, you can see the dress model. And the second one, you can see the floor. Now, the reason that I've put in the second camera is so that you can see what I'm doing, because as I realised that I need a lot of space to cut material, which means that you won't be able to see it because there is not enough room on the desk, because the desk is tiny, and if I was sitting there on the floor, all you would see is me looking down and not actually paying attention to the stream. So I thought, why not have two cameras and see how it goes. I can see that there is some messages already. Dual camera hype! You are heard, yay! And the dummy, yep. This is my wonderful dummy Helena, who is helping today. Thank you for the host, Cal Home, Sorrel, TC Loves Games, Duncan Land, and the lovely Disco Alpaca. Lucky for me, I have my phone, which is helping because I can now read the chat, because I can see that there is messages over there on the screen. But I can't actually read from here because I'm blind. So let us get started. And hello Helena. Helena would say hi, but you know, she's only a neck. She's got no vocal cords. She doesn't actually have a head, I'd like to imagine. I'd like to add, she stops about there. You can't actually see because it just cuts out the frame, but I am good today. Thank you, Calhoun. I am good. You will be able to see my face now. Hi guys. Yeah, you'll be able to see my face while I'm like crouching down, obviously. It sort of cuts off just at the top there, because that's really sort of the best angle that I can get, because there is actually a beam right behind the laptop, so I can't actually move it any further up, unfortunately, but we may do. So what you can see on the floor, let me just check with the chat quickly. She's very quiet. She is very quiet. But yeah, what you can see on the floor is the satin fabric that we've got for the underskirt, and then we have this shiny material, which is not quite as yellow as it looks on this camera. I literally just started this camera up. I didn't bother testing it, and as such, it looks quite yellow. But it's actually like shiny. I don't know how well you can see it, but yeah, it's see through. So that's going to be the outside of the skirt. Let me just. I know. Ooh, shiny. It is very shiny. So we're going to throw that over there for the moment, because we need to finish this one. Now, I did the top half of this bit. I also realised, unfortunately, the bottom of the skirt, half the bottom of the skirt, it's just a little bit too short. So I'm gonna just get rid of that little bug that's just crawling across my pattern right now. Excuse me. Yeah, so we're gonna cut this a little bit shorter than it was going to be originally, so that it all matches up. She says, not able to buy the scissors. Yeah, so let's go around this once and then we'll see. Actually, it's probably best to pin this down before I start trying to do that. But yeah, how are you guys today? I hope you are well. I hope that only... Actually, if I move... I tilt down a little bit more. There we go. You could almost just about see me. I'm hoping that... that the two cameras isn't too hideous, because I'll be honest, I don't look that great today. I don't usually look that great, to be honest, most days, but I'm hoping that having my face on camera won't deter people from watching the stream. If it does, please just let them know that, you know, it's not a permanent feature. It is purely for this project. Unfortunately, you probably can't actually see most of my face because I'm currently trying to stab some fabric with a rather bendy pin. There we go. Two cameras working well. This is the first time I've seen a moving robin. Try something a bit different today. Can you switch which one is large? I probably should have put that up before I started, but no, I did not test that. I didn't actually set that, I'll be honest. I can try. Try that on there before I stab myself. So if I... Right, you're gonna get some live overlay editing, guys. Let's check to see whether... No, that's good. Right. Oh. That was the alerts box. Ooh. And then... Ooh. Look at that cheeky little wine glass just hiding behind the camera there. It's okay, no one saw that. Totes profesh, guys. Totes profesh. There we go. And then if I move that there, then we could do that. There we go. No worries for the cutting out. It might make more sense to have overhead view as me. Yeah. There we go. Hey, Robin's floor. Yeah, apologies. The floor has not been hoovered yet. But as I'm making more of a mess anyway, probably no point just yet. Come on, get through the paper. So let's start it off there and just see how it goes. Now, I'll be honest, guys. I bought cheap fabric This is not going to be a £1 million project. We may not complete it today. It may not go well. But we shall see. Also, probably needed more pins. Can you guys still hear me right down here? I'm hoping so, because like I say, the microphone is actually up there, which is probably about here on Helena, which is quite far away from my face. Oh, you can. Awesome. So, in theory, that is the skirt started. Oh. Now, I have never tried this pattern before. For this style. So, we could pick this up and it could all turn to ribbons, in which case, I'll have to stop the stream for a little bit while I'm trying to set up something else. Ta-da! Okay, now in theory, this should... Oh, hang on. If I can find the mouse... We want to go to this screen. And to see how well that works. You can't really see it, but yeah, that works. So, that is the base of the skirt. Now, just a little quiet. Hang on. If I go back to that one. How does it sound now? Better or worse? That is the skirt. Now, we need to line this back up. To line that back up so we can get that bit straightened. So we pin it back up now that we've tested that did actually work. Brendan, how's it going? Apologies for you only being able to see the top of my head at the moment. There is a reason for this. You can get this dang thing lined back up again. Yeah, there we go. The reason that I'm putting this back together is so that I can flip it and just see how much needs cutting off of the edge. As you can see there, there's quite a bit that's missing off of this edge, so. We just use this as our guide. Go, and then flip that back over, and there we have a slightly better template. And now we can do that for the other bit of fabric, and they should in theory be the same length. So that is the skirt. It's still a little straight on this edge, but it's fine. Now what we are going to do is lose the scissors, because I put them up there on the bed where I didn't need them because I'm silly. Right, so we're just going to cut all the way down here. There is a line that is just perfect down the middle. Right, and then that's where we're going to sew it. We're going to sew, we needed to cut up quite a bit out of it because it's just a tad too big. Hey McLeod, how's it going? Yes, so we are going to cut a bit off of each side, and then after that, after we've done that bit, the other bit, I don't know how well you can see this, I have a little zip that will go in the top of it, so that it actually zips up, and it's a little invisible zip, so in theory, if I do this right, which I probably won't, but that's the amusement factor, if I do that right, you won't be able to see the zip at all. So I'm just going to cut off just a little bit off of either side. If you're doing something like this and you've cut it like this, then it's always best to try and cut off even bits on both sides rather than cut it off of one side, because otherwise then it could look a bit lopsided. There we go. So now do this. Now the problem is because the model doesn't actually fit me, because I think I'm saying to Will. So yeah, there's still quite a lot on both sides to get rid of. It's about that much. See, this has gone very wonky. There we go. And then just throw that bit, out there. There we go. And that should fit better now. Apologize. Oh, hey, Joy. Hey, how's it going? So apologies if I'm not keeping an eye on chat as much as I could be. Purely for reasons that I just generally can't see it. Right, that should fit now. So we are going to turn this bit inside out. I see that I've pressed the wrong button. Mr. Pixel Crash Music. I believe I know who that is. How's it going? I am currently making a mess, but what I'm actually doing, what I'm secretly doing, is I am making a skirt. Right, so I have the thing there. Now let us pin this, and we actually do need to measure. Ow, that was actually through my finger. So we actually need to measure how far from the top this is going to be. So it's going to be there. So if I put that one through there, then that hopefully, actually, I won't forget to stop before that point so that we can attach the zip. Yeah, hello Mr. Pixel. How is it going? I hope you are well. I'm liking the name change, by the way. Going to start sewing this now. Sew it all the way back up. I'm going to leave a little bit of a gap because we still actually need to hem the bottom of this. So if I was to stitch this all the way up, then that might cause a few issues. When we do that in a minute. Willoughby test streams. Long weekend of fiddling with stream settings ahead. Oh, nice! There will not be test streams because when I fail, I like to fail 100%. So how close do you think you are to starting the streams now? And I ask this not to try and put pressure on you, but basically I've had this bottle of wine sitting in the cupboard from Christmas, and as soon as I found out that you were going to start streaming again, I promised myself I was not going to open it until you started, as a celebration. And there has been a few days I really do with that bottle of wine. Well, now I know there's wine waiting, I better get moving. I mean, failing that, I could just stick it in my bag and bring it with me when I head up in a few weeks. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. Because I am well and truly looking forward to wine bottles. Other drinking games you can play to a pixel stream. I suppose that is a question. I really should be doing these stitches a bit smaller. I'm getting so excited. I'm making this completely untidy. Fortunately, this is the bottom of the skirt, and it's also going to be the underskirt, so you're not going to be able to see anyway. Well, I hope not. Yes, and also yes, you can play when Pixel drinks. You always win. That sounds good. Sounds as though it could be a bit hardcore for me. Yeah, I sense that if I did that, I would get very drunk. I think I do recall quite a few streams I don't quite remember the end of, for similar reasons. I'd like to just add a little public service announcement here. If you can't feel your fingers, it's probably best to take extra caution when sewing, because I did actually just stitch some of that through my finger and I didn't notice. So, whoops. You got cold hands. They're not the warmest, but no, I think it's literally more that I've burnt them, scalded them, and stabbed them with sewing needles enough times that I no longer feel my fingers. Which can be both a blessing and a curse. But I keep moving the scissors, and now I'm like, oh. Never mind, I found the scissors. Probably if I looked at the camera rather than looked around myself, I would be able to see them. Right, so let's just take those out. And you can see from that. See from that that it's starting to look more like a skirt now. So if we flip that back inside out, because it will need to be inside out when we attach the other half. Okay, and then we pop that up there, and now for the fun bit of folding this back up to do the same again. I will need to start this bit. Oh. My old granny knees allow me to. The only trouble with this being see-through is you just can't quite see. If you're holding it or not. The answer is no. No, I was not. flip this and just make it a little bit easier. And there we go. So did you buy a second camera? No, so this camera right here I'm pointing at, this is actually the laptop camera. So this is the pre-built camera. This one up here that I'm now pointing to, the one that's pointing down, this is actually the camera that I usually stream from, which is just a little normal web camera. That's what I usually use. But I have, for today, I have moved the laptop over this side of the room, so it's actually sitting on top of my printer, so that I can use that camera as well as the normal web camera. Well done, I'm streaming. Yeah, it's working really well. Yeah, it's not working too badly, is it? Oh. Excuse me, getting severe cramp in my toe. For no other reason than I've moved it wrong. And that foot doesn't quite bend for me. Right. I'm hoping that you can still see enough of what I'm doing for it to all make sense, because I realise I am pretty much leaning over the camera. Which is why it actually works up there. Because if it was sitting behind me, you wouldn't be able to see anything. So, we need to pin this bit first. I love her dearly, but she's in the way. But I'd also like to add that for anyone in here, it is a little bit crafty, and that would like to try this for themselves, but doesn't really have patterns or anything. This stuff that I've got here that I'm making this pattern out of, believe it or not, totally free. Did not cost me a single thing, and I will tell you the reason why is because this actually came out of a large Amazon box order. Yep, this is the rather annoying paper packaging stuff that Amazon use now to wrap their goodies in, and I thought, you know what, that's nice and thick, that'll make a great pattern. Most people, they would use newspaper, but don't really have any because we don't really read papers in this house. It just so happened that I had a massive wadge of it that's been sitting in my room getting in the way, and I suddenly thought this would be perfect. It's a massive sheet of it. Yeah, it came in this massive long sheet. I couldn't do anything else with it. and it seemed such a waste to throw it away. So I thought, why if we use it for something? Right, so that is the waste of it. It's gone. And now we probably want to pin this bit just for the first bit, because it is so prone to moving, this stuff. It's so thin. Nice recycling. Yeah, it's really good as well. My mum noise-proofed her room with Amazon boxes. You see, this is kind of ingenuity that we need nowadays, and that's the thing. It's like, stuff like this, people wouldn't turn a blind eye to just picking it up and throwing it in a bin. Or they think that, you know, recycling is just sticking it in a green tub outside your house and, you know, letting someone else make do with it, but it really is one of the easiest things, you know, for a creative person to go, oh, actually, I think I might use that. And I think in a sense I take that for granted. Had a similar issue with this one, that it is a little bit small. As you can see. So we're just gonna sort of snip off the offending bits. I really probably should put the bin over here, shouldn't I? There we are. And just try and make it a bit even. I don't really mind too much if it's a bit shorter than the bottom layer. There we go. And that should be the other part of the skirt. Just pull out all the pins. All the pins. I have used every single one of the pins that I own to make this. So you can see how serious I am. Right. Now we can go. Ta-da! Oh. At least we could. Right. Now, it's totally fine that this bit is going a bit weird and wonky, because I'm going to cut this bit out anyway. The only trouble is, it's so shimmery and it's so thin that I can't quite see where the fabric is. There you go. Yeah, went a little bit wonky, that's fine. Okay, and now we are going to do the same again. So we're going to flip this inside out, You're gonna painstakingly line up those edges because I can't actually see it very well. And then we are gonna pin it. And we're gonna measure where the just try and get this. With this one, I've decided that I was never going to find a thread that would match this, so I've decided to use this nice lemon yellow, so hopefully that will look alright with this fabric. I'll be honest, this may be the hardest part of the entire project because I can't bloody see it. Okay, so it's really stretchy. Right, so we're gonna stop about here on this one. Bobby pins, terrapins, all the pins. Exactly. Exactly. Oh. I don't actually know how well you guys can see this. I see there. On the camera. You're probably looking at this thinking, what are you on about? This is perfectly alright to look at. But you see, when you're faced with this, as I am, you would not be able to see a darned thing of it. And I have just realised that I actually needed another needle for the yellow. And the yellow thread has immediately rolled straight under the fabric and hidden itself. Because it's that useful. I think it's safe to say I'm definitely hoovering this floor this weekend. And also that I'm probably not drinking that cup of tea that I've just remembered was left on my desk about an hour ago. Checking that I'm not missing anything in the chat. So all looks good here. Right, so we are going to do the same again. We'll leave a little bit of a gap. Flip this over. Yep, so again, we'll leave a bit of a gap at the bottom. So that we can hem that in a moment. quotes already. Though the camera, it looks a bit glittery. Yeah, it looks sparkly on the camera. I think the thing is because I'm sitting here on the floor, sort of sitting with it on the carpet, the camera can't pick up quite how see-through it is. But it's like, if you have net curtains, it is essentially that material. But in a gold. It really does like look like liquid gold. You would think that this was actually a you could easily mistake this for liquid gold, I'll be honest. It's so thin. Which to be fair is exactly what I was expecting of it. So it does not disappoint in any way. This is precisely what I wanted. We shall see just how well this works. I don't know how well this will work once it's sewn. Ouch. She says, sticking her finger directly in the path of the needle. We got a knot. Like, please don't get a knot in this. I'll have to rip it all out and start again because there is no way that won't be noticeable. Because you can literally see the thread through both sides of the fabric. You can't see it on the camera because again, it's not heavily detailed. But as I'm sewing this, I can see both sides of the thread. Well, I can see the thread through both sides of the fabric, rather. Just to give an indication of how sheer this fabric is. Oops. Nearly made a stitch there I did not want. Just push that back out. So we're almost at the point of the zip, or at least where the zip will be. Now, I will admit that I have never once put a zip into a single item of clothing. I don't have the first darn clue how I'm going to do this, which to be honest has been the phrase of this entire project, because this is all completely new to me. As it's streaming with two cameras and being on them, to be fair. So it's all quite new. All about the tension, I guess, for Zipsy. Yeah. Yeah, you sort of don't want it to end up too baggy. It does help me, at least, that the one that I've bought the zip that I actually bought for this is an invisible zip. Well, based on Sony, zips aren't a problem at all. Yeah, it's just everything else in the sewing bee that's the issue. Right, so you can see the thread. But that's alright. Okay, so I will hem these off stream because that will take the longest time ever. And as much as I know that you guys love to support me, I don't think you'll have the tolerance for that. Right, so this is the inside. So we then want to put this bit, which is also inside out. Yeah. So we want to put this in here. Actually, it might be easier to turn this the right way up and then pin it and then flip it back in. I think I'm the best way to do this. Right, so that's the back, and then that's the back. So then if I throw that there, you can start to see this really taking shape now. So this is where the zip will be, and we are just gonna yeah, this is about might be easier if I do this. Pull this down and then pin it. Never seen anyone have a complete disaster related to zips. When Columbus went to the moon, people said it wasn't possible. Maybe I'm mixing up my history. Hashtag fact check. That's true, I bumped into Columbus when I was on the moon getting cheese. Ross and Gromit there too. No, that went a few years after. Did see Robot though.
You guys.
Now, let's just hold this fabric and pin it before it escapes again, as it is trying to do right now. Right, you shall stay. You shall not go to the ball. I can sense it has moved quite a bit. Oh, and the reason is because I'm about to pin it inside out. It's good to notice that. I'm not sure how I did that because I'm pretty sure it wasn't inside out to begin with. Right, turn it around, flip it over. Start again. Start again the right way. Always check, guys. Always check your work. Whatever it is, always make sure that you got it right the first time so that you don't have to go and undo it all later. Since I'm actually here, since it's here, I do actually need to pin the zip in place. Need to stop the bloody fabric moving. Edges of this bit first. There we go. Ooh, garlic bread is done. Nice. Right. And now, this zip is where it could all go horribly wrong. So like I say, I have never even attempted a zip before. So it may not work, guys. It may not work. just slightly unorthodox way of keeping the pins out of the way till I need them. Just pin them to your trousers. Make sure that what you're pinning to your trousers is only the pins and not the fabric that you're about to sew. There we go. Find one half of it's pinned. So I'm gonna start sewing that bit on. Again, apologies that I'm not really interacting with you guys as much as I usually would be. This takes a little bit more concentration to make sure that I don't do something utterly stupid on the camera. and also to make sure that I'm trying to get... I want to get this right as much as I also want it to be entertaining. So obviously if messing this up and, you know, picking it up and it all just falls apart is amusing to you guys, then obviously I have done my job. But, you know, if getting it right first time is also, you know, something that you guys can marvel at, then, obviously I want to try and make it as good as possible. Ow. Especially as I say, this is the first time that I will have attempted anything like this. Much less on camera in full view of everyone. I just want to make sure... make sure it's as even as possible. It has strayed a little at the bottom of the zip, but you know, can't really complain too much. We believe in you, Robin. Aww, thanks, Will. Remind me, someone. Before I end the stream, that I do actually have something I want to show off, other than this skirt. Which came in the post today. Just throw that one out. Throw that one out of everyone. And hopefully it's something that you guys will be interested in. so tempted to doing little poppers. If I took risks, I probably wouldn't have gone out of bed. Hey, that sounds like a good idea. Well, I woke up this morning. I'll be honest, I could have quite easily stayed in bed. I did not feel that great. I was just like, ugh, I really do not feel like working right now. I also woke up at like 5 o'clock this morning and couldn't go back to sleep, so that didn't really help me either. Like running on pure fumes right now. Zip is good. Something to show off. Ooh, sounds promising. On top of the other thing that I have, my Wi-Fi Wars tickets turned up today, of which I cannot remember if I mentioned. Right, there's one half of the zip. Oh, throwing pins everywhere. That's a good start. Now, for my next trick, I shall complete the zip. We got we've just hit the 1 hour 15 mark. Come on, skirt, play ball. Doesn't want to turn inside out, which is what I need it to do, because it's all twisted on itself and it won't actually, can't get the zip in. Right, there we go. That's better. Right, let's see if I can maneuver it now so that I can put the zip in place. Fabric, why must you be so complicated? Right, keep it. You sit there. Nope. There we go. It is having none of it. I sense that the gold fabric might not be the same size as the black fabric, because it seems quite smooshed. So I may have to make some nips and tucks in that as we go along later. But no matter. want it. There we go. If I had to get it so that I can pin it in place without distorting it. Especially don't sew it to the other side of the fabric because that's not going to help. Now, I'll be honest, there is probably a much easier way of doing this, because I am making this look hard as fuck. But it is just not plain ball. Trying to get the zip to stay still, so that I can pin it to the fabric. So, to make sure that the fabric stays still, so then it's not covering the zip completely. Ah, it's all going wrong, guys. It is all going wrong. We will get there. Even if I have to do a few more squares to do it. Yeah, brave barefoot with pins. I know. Right, let's try. Try that again. See, somewhere this has slipped slightly. a few minutes of wrestling and a bit of nonsensical way of going about it, but got there in the end. Suspected. The zip is a bit of a faff, I won't lie. This one is not going to be great. Trying, but. Right. Trying to get this fabric to line up is a bit faffy. There is being because the top layer moves, but it doesn't move with the bottom layer, so it wraps around it, which is fine, but then it leaves a gap. And then when you try and pin it, it shifts again, and then you end up with this massive hole. And you don't want the massive hole. Stitch it before it comes out again. Once the zip is in, we've got about another half hour after this bit. Once the zip is in, the skirt is kind of finished, in a sense. And then I'll just try and tidy it up a little bit. And then I'll finish the seams, not the seams, like the hem off stream. Because that will be the boring part. Home time for me. Good luck with the rest of the skirt. I have to catch up to find out what surprises. Ah, see you later, Cal Home. Robin, you should be doing this for a living. If it all goes well, you know, maybe, like I say, if I pick it up and the skirt falls off, then might have to rethink that as a career. apologize. I'm sort of like sitting out the camera a little bit now. Hopefully when I get my desk, it'll be a lot easier to do projects like this because there'll be room on the actual desk. Or at the very least, I'll be able to have the camera a bit closer so you'll actually be able to see what I'm working on. Rather than this, where it's sort of the camera itself is literally hung from a beam above me. So, a bit like with the microphone, I'm not actually anywhere near it. Okay. Did I sew it all the way? Yeah, I did sew it all the way to the top on that one. Sew it all the way to the top on this bit just to make it even. After a few swear words, a lot of faffing, and a few stabbed fingers, that zip is now in. Which means, in theory, the skirt is pretty much complete. Aside from the tidying. Now, you can't blast. You can see the zip on one side, but you can't really see it on the other. It's not great, guys. It's not great. Don't know if you can, how well you can see that zip. Yeah, it's not the neatest. If I pin that. If I throw that the right way up, the outer skirt has sort of got itself tangled. The model isn't actually my size. The model is too thin. But hopefully I can pin this very quickly. You should get a basic idea of what it's gonna look like when it's finished.
if I just
go back to that one.
If I just finish pinning this, we do need to make a few adjustments.
You can see there sort of what we're going for. Oh. Some of the skirt is a bit shorter in some places than others. But if I just pull that forward a little bit, you can see that the skirt is pretty much complete. I'll just pull that around the back there. So, yeah, that's not turned out too bad. Like I said, I've had to pin it to the back of the model, which you can't see, for good reason, because, yeah, it's a bit of a mess around the back. there's quite a lot of overlapping fabric where I've had to pin it to the model because the model is too thin. But that is essentially a skirt. As you can see, it's quite nice and light and moves quite a bit. Oh, I think it will. It's not too bad. Like I said, we've got a little bit of a discrepancy there. Looks like I cut the fabric a bit short. Well, that might be because it was already a bit short. And then it's slightly longer there. Oh dear. It's quite a bit shorter there. but yeah. Oh, thank you, Brendan. So I think... Oh, thank you, Ojoy. See if I can even it out a little bit. No. That looks like it is just cut a bit wonky. Not to worry. Like I say, it's sort of like the first time I've tried a project of this magnitude. So I wasn't expecting it to turn out amazing. hey the crust. Ah, oh, thank you, McLeod. As first attempt, you should be chuffed. Yeah. I think it's gone pretty darn well. I probably need to work on the fabric cutting a little bit. but as it goes, I think that's done pretty well. So I might call it a little bit early, because it's going to take me a little while to clear everything up and check that I've not left any pins on the floor and all that stuff. So sorry that you've only just come in the crossed. Please don't take it personally. but before I go... Aw, thank you, Brendan. Before I go, I want to show you guys... what came in the post today, which is these little stickers, little crafty rebel stickers. Are they the most adorable little things you've ever seen? Let me just see if I can get a close up to that. Okay, little crafty queen.
who usually sits in the bottom of the camera down there, but I had to change everything. But yeah, so these are for the Patreons. If you donate for £5 a month, you get two of these little stickers and a candle, a votive candle or wax melt of your choice, from my shop. And yeah, that was the little surprise. Yes, that was the thing to show you, Will. So those have arrived today and they are super cute and tiny. I may at some point be giving them away on the stream, because I think it would be nice to give you guys a little bit of something that... Oh, excuse me. Ooh, knee fell over. not so great at the balancing. But... yeah. It's really... It turned out really, really nice and well there. So, I am going to call it a bit early. Like, tidy all of that fabric-y mess up. But thank you all so much for coming and hanging out with me today. Like I say, sorry that I wasn't so talkative or interactive with the chat and stuff. But we will be back tomorrow. Tomorrow 5 p.m. for some Sims 1. And then it will be Assassin's Creed for Monday, and then more sewing on Wednesday. And probably more sewing on Friday as well. Thank you all so much, and I will see you later. I will see if I can find someone to raid, actually. Let me just switch over to my little end screen down here, who takes prefer. Oh no, Tungan! Oh, I'm so sorry, you missed everything! Oh, I feel really bad now. Thank you guys so much. So I'm just gonna see if I can find someone to raid. If I remember how Twitch works. I have forgotten. But yeah, I'm so sorry, Duncan. I might actually put some reruns on at some point. I might do that over Sunday. Okay, so we are going to go
we can probably
Red Rains, in the hopes that I actually get to say hi to
okay
him
so
today.
We'll do one more game. You want to play this again?
Yeah, sure, that's fine.
One more game in this, fine. Hopefully I don't fail in this time. I can't be doing this again.
Summerman wants to know how he can take part in the giveaway. Do you have any idea, Dave?
I
think he's just
thank you all so much for coming, and I will see you later. Bye bye.